Well, Megan, all week long as we've been doing our interviews, we've been trying to figure out who got the better of who in the training room and the main event. And, you know, they're both being a little guarded or they kind of frame it up. So in your experience with them, have you figured out who was getting the better of who?
You know, it's a good question. But I also think how much does it really matter? You know, I think that there are times where you guys all go to different gyms and you'll see sometimes people who haven't even had a pro fight yet putting it on somebody who's ranked in the UFC. And I think, you know, yes, there's a lot we can take away from that, especially certain tricks that each one may have. But I don't think it necessarily matters. And it's been a long time since they have really trained together. So I think while it's fun to talk about, I don't know how much, you know, it necessarily comes into play once that cage door closes behind them.
I want to ask you about the co-main event as well. I think we're all trying to figure out the psychology of Macy Barber, right? I mean, the first loss. And it was interesting, when we talked to her, she talked about the injury more than she talked about the loss. You know what I mean? So what do you think? I mean, you had a chance to speak with her. Where do you think her head's at, and has she progressed from that?
I think she's in a really good place, actually. I just spoke with her backstage, and you're right. She did talk about the injury a lot. But I think, you know, with the difficulties of an injury like that also comes some positives, which is giving her body rest that she hasn't had in a very long time. She's been training since she was a little kid. So I think when you see somebody who has a long layoff, they start to feel better all around, because maybe you just learn to live with certain things. And maybe that's just a part of, you know, this always aches, but it's just how it is. Well, she's coming in here really, really actually refreshed and able to rehab not just her knee, but her entire body. And I think having the time off maybe does make you a little bit hungrier. I think this is a great platform for her. We know she always performs when the spotlight is on her. So I think it's going to be really interesting to see how she comes back against a very game opponent.
Yeah. And obviously everybody's focused on the title fight, the main event, but is there an under the radar either a matchup or a storyline or something that you uncover that you think people need to be paying attention to?
Yeah, well, I think actually all the early prelims are really interesting. Ricky Simone and Brian Kelleher, Miranda Maverick and Jillian Robertson, I really like that matchup. I think there's some great ones. Kelvin Gastelum and Ian Heinisch. I think the tide can turn either way in that matchup. There's a lot on the line there. So I think this card is actually very stacked. I think there's a lot of talent on there, and I'm looking forward to, you know, really from that first fight on, I think there's going to be a lot of great action there.
I saw you tease on social media, UFC Connected, a new project. what can you tell us about that?
Yeah, so there, UFC Connected is a new magazine show, which TBD on the date it airs. I guess somebody should have told me that, but I really don't know. But there will be an English, Spanish, and Portuguese version. I am your English host. And so, you know, hopefully we'll be doing those around once a month, maybe even more often. But it's, if you remember The Ultimate Insider, which John Anik hosted and then I hosted as well, it's very similar to that. So different features, well-done features from all around the world of our athletes that maybe you don't get to see their journeys after they're in the octagon, or maybe somebody who's not necessarily a household name. It's being able to tell those different stories in a great, easy-to-digest way.
Last thing for me, the long form podcast. Is there still just been one episode, or what's the update on that?
Oh my gosh, thank you for asking, because it's sort of my passion project. There's been two
episodes.
The first
episode was great.
Hey, thank you so much, Ian. I mean, you can't ask for a better story than Ian Heinisch, right? We had an episode with Rose Namajunas, and then hopefully we will actually start recording. We have my list of interviews I want to do for that is a mile long, and I feel like they're probably so annoyed with me in the other building with how much I'm kind of asking for all these extra projects, but it's something I found that fighters really resonated with, being able to tell their own stories in their own words. And yes, we know so much about them once they get into the octagon, but like, what makes a fighter? I mean, I can speak from experience that there's got to be something that makes you want to get into that octagon. And, you know, to see like my husband and his story and what makes him who he is, I would want people to know that whole story of Joseph. So to be able to give others the platform to know the whole story of, hey, this is how I grew up, these are the things I've overcame, and now I found success in the octagon. And to stop the story there, I think is really fun too, because it doesn't mean you have to be a mixed martial arts fan even to relate to these stories, to find something to hold on to from these stories. So hopefully those will start being released late February, early March, and then we'll continue with those, because it is something I truly love doing.
And I apologize for the last bit. What was the title of it? I forgot. Is it just on the UFC Unfiltered feed?
Yeah, it's called Becoming a Fighter, and hopefully we're actually going to expand into somewhat of an audio network. There's actually a great series, I'm not sure if you got to listen to it, hosted by Force Griffin, about training camps. And so that you can also find on the Unfiltered feed, but hopefully you'll start seeing a bigger audio network in terms of podcasts that the UFC produces, and we'll kind of each have our own little branch.
Hey, Megan, back here.
Hi.
Looking beautiful. Congratulations on all your continued success.
Thanks.
And on the note of podcasts, I do know that you launched your very own podcast, At Home with Ben Olivi, with Joe. Can you kind of, you know, give your fans a bit more of an insight on it and what they can expect every week when they tune in?
Oh, thanks for asking. Yeah, man, that was something that I was very bashful about doing. I'm not necessarily one that wanted to. You guys see that we've opened our home a lot to different documentaries and projects within the UFC, but to do something like that where we're just talking about, like, I don't know, the Britney Spears documentary or whatever it may be, you know, it's daunting for us. We're kind of bashful in that regard. So it's been nice, and it's really been nice for Joe to have a platform like that to see him outside of just being a fighter and kind of expand and how much he loves movies and music and art and stuff like that. So yeah, every week you'll hear from us. The reception's been great, and which is nice, but you know, I'm still not totally comfortable with the idea, but hopefully I will be as we go along.
Megan over here. Megan, watching the broadcast, a lot of people want to know, how do you pull off the disappearing act when you're doing the hit during the walkout? Can you explain how that shot and just what you're doing that we don't see off camera when you disappear?
Yeah, that's a good question. We work with, like, the most talented production team in sports, I swear. The things that we are able to do, the creativity. And so those shots are something we do rehearse. I come in much earlier before everybody else, and so we'll spend time, and that's something we have to nail. So in rehearsal, whatever I say for however long we go, that's what we plan on. So we release fighters for their walk based on how long I took during those rehearsals. So I have to be exactly how I was in that practice run. And so what you'll see is I'll walk forward, the camera will pass me, someone actually opens the stanchion, and then I exit. The fighter walks by. So hopefully no one ever runs during that time, because it would not work out if they did.
Thank you.
Thanks. Good. Thanks, guys.